Yes people, what's happening? It's Will here, back again with another vlog for you on the Frankie Allen channel. Just wanted to come on and introduce this first. This particular vlog is from our second stop on a three-stop tour of Lincolnshire we went on in November 2019. This following on from the Boston vlog you might have watched last time is the 8th of November 2019, specifically the Saturday night sold out show at the Beachcomber in Cleethorpes. Unbelievable event. We had a good laugh doing it as well. Frank took 5 hours driving there, which I'll show you in the vlog. Kilbo got trolled, which I thought was hilarious. And yeah, Frank was just being his usual grumpy self, saying that he wanted to butt people, which is typical Frank. So yeah, Tuesdays, 7 o'clock, every single week back on this channel is a new vlog. So make sure you get yourself subscribed, thumb up, notification bell, and all the rest of it. So look, enjoy the vlog. Big thanks for your support. Back to live shows soon. All the shows will be linked in the description. If you want to buy tickets, get yourself along, come meet us live and have a good laugh. So enjoy the vlog, keep yourself sane. Hopefully this takes your mind off the current situation. All the best, speak soon, nice one. What's happening everyone? Heading up to Cleethorpes tonight, a place called the Beachcomber, as part of our second leg out of three of the Lincolnshire tour. And we've been stuck in traffic for how long?
2 hours.
Yeah, so we left the house at about
2 o'clock.
No, it was a bit later than that, wasn't it? Half two, 23. It's now 6:08. And we're still driving. I'll just give you an idea of what the traffic's like. Proper standstill, literally. It's been boring as hell. Hopefully we're gonna get there on time. I'm pretty sure we will do. We've got Waze going on Frankie's phone right now. An hour and a half to go, still arriving there before 8. Good job Mackie, who was with us last night. The sound guy took our banners and stuff and he said he's going to set everything up. And he's a brilliant sound tech as well, so I know the mics and stuff are going to be spot on. There's no need to worry about that. Kilbo's already going to be there. I just need to bring him on stage at 8 o'clock. So let's hope
Mackie,
we fucking get there.
Well, Mackie, you'll have to bring him on if we're not there, Will.
No, it'll be fine, it'll be fine. We're due to arrive at 20 to 8 anyway. This is where the crash was, the first crash point apparently. So they must have cleared it. Fucking hell, there's 4 crash points the same. These are crash points.
I've never known anything like this in my life.
On the Waze app, if anyone's got it, these are where the crashes have been. And it's just fucking...
It's ridiculous, I've never seen anything like it in my life.
So yeah, we're almost moving again. Due to get there early enough. Good job we left fucking early. We were going to leave at what, 6?
We were going to leave at 4 o'clock, we would have been fucked, yeah.
Yeah, we would have been totally fucked. We would have missed the show and everything, but thank God, an hour and 28 minutes to go. So we will catch you when we get to the venue. Time is 7:40. We've got 10 minutes until we get to the venue, 8 minutes in fact. We're definitely going to be on time by the skin of our teeth. We've been in the car for 5 hours for what is a 2-hour 45 journey. Standstill traffic, fucking ridiculous. Kilbo's been there for about half an hour sorting things out for us. I'm looking forward to getting on stage, to be honest with you, to get a bit of vibrancy going. Are you?
Well, yeah, just to get back in the real world.
Yeah,
you feel like a zombie.
Yeah, feel absolutely.
Just being in a car for 5 hours, just like for 2.5 hours, you're just sitting in a queue.
But we'll catch you when we get to Cleethorpes. We're literally 7 minutes from the venue, so see you in a bit. So we've arrived in Cleethorpes. Haven't even been and checked the room yet. Grant, one of the lads who's running the event tonight, just come and met us at the back door. Kilvo's in here, and Frank's just making himself comfortable after this long journey. So we'll go in and see the lads and see what's going on. Here we go. What's happening?
Alright.
How's it going, Jake?
Alright, good.
Good night last night, fella.
Yeah.
Enjoy it.
I've just been here waiting for you. I was getting lonely.
Frank, what were you saying about the good luck thing?
Not the strange things that you notice over the years. Like since we've been working with Jimmy, James Kilbo, it doesn't matter what time we leave, he always gets to the venue before us. Like for instance, we left at 2 o'clock today. What time do you leave, Jim?
Half four.
He left at half four, but he got here before us. It's a weird thing. It's strange. He just seems to, don't know what it is, like as though we're cursed.
Time now for Eyewitness News, call 12 for action. It's a little known law that many drivers wish more people knew about.
Driving too slow in the passing lane is against the law in just about every state. Consumer reporter Susan Hogan joins us now with the details.
Well, that's right. It wasn't long ago Call 12 for Action told you about a local man who got a ticket for going too slow in the fast lane. It created a huge buzz everywhere. Now we're following up and learning more states are cracking down on slow pokes.
So, Kilva, what are you up to here? Secrets of the business, go on.
Secrets, every now and again I'll write a little few gags. Not gags, just words to remind me, just of areas around the area.
We're here. On your hand. So what have you got?
I've got
Nunny,
Nunsthorpe
and Shagging Leaves.
Okay, now, out of curiosity, why have you got those on your hand, just so people know?
Because in the Daily Mail lately, there's been a...
No, just like, I mean, the psychological aspect.
Psychological, I don't even look at it, to be honest. I don't even just quickly put it on there.
Put it.
Don't be fucking putting this on that vlog, because you're not...
Frank, seriously, what's the vibe with him with the thing? What do you think?
With which? Tell him to fuck off, Frank.
Yeah, it's Si. Si, what's happening? You okay? Oh, we've got Jay in here as well. What's happening? And Jay Connors in here again. Here with Mackie.
Hello, good evening.
In his little nice technical station that he's got in the booth.
Looking good tonight, Will.
Looking fantastic, so we're just checking. He's got all the presets sorted for the lights. Looking fantastic, all spot
ready.
On.
We're all ready to go.
Beta roll. I've just gone outside to set up and some fella was being, as Jay would call it, chewy. Or as Frank would call it, where is Frank? Cheesy. With me in the front. Basically, he was just like, I wanna come out. He went, are you Frankie Allen? I said, you know who you've fucking come to see, mate? He went, are you the singer? I said, are you a fucking singer? So I said to Jay, there's a fella there, they'll start trying to give you lips straight away as soon as you come out, and your reaction was?
I just said, fuck it, I'll just tell him I'll take him outside, not fuck out of him.
Frankie, you're up for it?
Well, I'm just in the mood, I've been sitting on the motorway for 3 hours, so I'm just in the mood for some dickhead to start being funny. And I won't take him outside, I'll just jump off the stage and butt him right in the face.
Hi, Jackie. How are you doing, mate? All right, you're the head of this pack behind you, you're the shagger. What are you doing with the tires, though? You're still working. You look a bit like fucking Father Christmas. But we've got the picket. You want that? You have to go what? Yeah. Oh, right. I don't know what you fucking bought in your pocket or anything. What do you do, Pop? What do you do?
Bits and pieces.
Bits and pieces? Fuck it, he's definitely going to be on Predators Exposed next week. We don't even need to fucking talk to those girls.
What a
catch.
What are you doing?
Fucking hands.
I'll tell you what I thought was funny. There was a fella in the crowd, that might be able to get some footage so you can see it. And he looked like Father Christmas. And he was going, fucking hell, you look like Father Christmas without the beard. And then he referenced him about 4 times. And I just started creasing because I thought, where the fuck are you going with this? And he went, yeah, it'll be emptying the sack on him later. What do you think of the show?
Yeah, good crowd, great crowd. They loved it, so we had a good laugh, didn't we?
Yeah, we set the tripod up. Frank's in there, I set the tripod up, we got it all ready to go. Yeah, Jay said to me,
I left it with Will, who was a perfect cameraman.
Fucking brilliant, and I forgot to press record.
You forgot to press fucking record.
So yeah, did you enjoy it?
Yeah, I loved it. Great crowd.
Frank's just having fish and chips in here. I'm in the back parched, I need to go and get a drink from somewhere.
He's just chilling here.
Yeah.
He loves it.
You looking forward to getting on?
Yeah, you know, give him a few minutes. What time is it now, 9?
What time is it?
10 to 9.
What time do you reckon we're going 9?
Maybe just after 9, yeah.
9:05.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Right, I just need to get a drink. Looking forward to it, Frank.
Yeah, I'm starving, but I've had some nice fish and chips now, it's sound.
Cool. Right, nice one.
But the fish was a bit too fresh.
Why?
You let me chips.
No, never. Chips are still there.
This is great banter. It really is.
Just with Scott in the back here. Scott, what have you brought, mate? Hospitality.
Couple of beers.
So I'm talking sauls. About.
A
couple of sauls he's brought in. And what was I going to say? Scott's just watched Jay again. What do you think, Scott?
Right, unbelievable.
Second night, yeah?
Yeah, second night. Still laughing my tits off his mint. Nice one.
Cheers. Smashed it, Jay. Well done, fella. Jay's just come off there. Simon is running the show tonight. What do you think, mate?
Absolutely superb as last night, mate. Yeah, brilliant again.
And killed the area again.
Yeah, of course he did. And so as you said, there's a couple. What's the script of the couple?
Dan Baldwin McGee is Mike Baldwin McGee. His lad plays football for me, so okay. it's their 17th wedding anniversary.
So Sa's going to bring them in here, and then so Frank can meet them, and then he's going to strip out of them when he gets on stage. Is that right?
No, not really. I'll get someone else. Leave them alone.
So yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, mention a bit of Harry Potter. Harry Potter's put a bit of weight on.
So Frank's just finished his first spot. How did you find it?
Doing a good crowd, but I had to work, you know, tonight I had to work hard. Mm-hmm. He had a tendency to try and be a bit noisy and talk, so I had to keep on top of him, yeah.
He's getting me one. Si, thanks very much. James has just gone to bye to you. Yeah. Si again. Si, what do you think?
Absolutely superb. More brutal than last night. I thought it was. That's why I'm at the back.
Over the top.
I'm with Nick.
Wedding anniversary.
Good lad, him, yeah.
Good lad. Is he come back in?
No,
man. All right, yeah, you're okay.
Box office, what?
What's happening, fella?
I tell you what, Cleethorpes is spinning the toilet there. They love you.
They like it, yeah.
Yeah, they do.
It's the first time you've been to the show, isn't it? How did you find it?
I didn't get up. Hey, I was honest, just sat down permanently. Gotta just didn't get up.
Gotta say, very good. Pull the bottles out of that book or someone. We'll use the buckets.
Jay's shooting off.
We're shooting off.
We were talking about, you know, you may as well be honest about what you thought of the audience and the difference.
Tonight, the guy who organised the thing, it's not our show, so he's invited a lot of people here. Some of the people, it's obvious to me. Anyway, it's not like Frankie Allen's show, not fans. Some people maybe didn't really know who it was. So yeah. When it went on, I mean, it went down great, but I had to work, you know, work hard. It wasn't some of my own shows where shows that Will puts on, where you just pick the mic up, he starts talking, everyone starts laughing for nothing.
Yeah.
I had to work hard, you know. But it went well anyway, but so not to worry.
Jake's absolutely smashed it tonight. Enjoy himself. No. He's going to a festival with his new windbreaker on, and it's just fantastic. I think, you know, for someone who, how long have you been doing it now, Jay?
It's coming up 9 months, isn't it?
Okay, 9 months.
That's my 29th gig.
Think about this. 9 months. Who have you supported? What comics have you supported? Big names.
Patrick Monaghan. Frankie Allen. Yeah. Clinton Baptiste. Archie Kelly. Lords. I'm trying to think. Like,
he's absolutely 8 months in.
Angelo Serafini.
Eight months in.
Next
you listen to those names, you think of, like, he's going out there, smashed it in front of all these people, and is still available to book as an Elton John tribute act. If you'd like to go through me, or you'd like to go through his page, James Kilvington Comedy, and he also goes out as an impressionist of the wrestler Mickey Rourke.
Yeah, Mickey Rourke. I'm gonna go out with my top off. I also go on with Will go out, and now we do it. Don't Let the Sun Go Down on Us by Elton John and George Michael. You can guess which one's which.
Right, this fella's heading off. Smashed it tonight again.
Yeah.
Heading to Scunthorpe tomorrow.
Yeah.
So,
back to bed for me. Go to fucking probably just go and have a cup of tea.
Tamsy.
Have a quick fucking. And then go to bed.
I don't know what you mean, mate. But yeah, right, Jay smashed it tonight. Everyone who came to Cleethorpes, make sure you go follow his page. What do they follow?
James Kilvington Comedy. If you don't follow it, you're losing out.
Sounds. Also, you can hashtag Elton John Tribute.
Elton John Tribute and George Michael there.
It'll be on there. Nice one. We'll be right back.
Frank, finished up, what do you think?
Great. Too rough and ready. But, you know, all in all, great night. You know, and it's hard work.
Hey everyone, so we're heading home now. I've just had a McDonald's. Again, I had one last night. I was starving. What did you have before? Fish and chips, isn't it?
Fish and chips and peas was lovely.
It's very rare that we do events through promoters or through venue owners anymore. We kind of just book all of our own shows. But the lads were very hospitable with us tonight, weren't they?
Nice lads, yeah.
Yeah. Grant and Scott and Simon. Simon and Grant run the company together. Scott helps out. And they were really, really nice. No late events. Go follow them on Facebook or whatever. And if you're in Lincolnshire, they bring a lot of big names to Lincolnshire. Night was a total success. Kilvo absolutely smashed it again. He gets better and better. He's gonna be something crazy soon. Him, he's gonna smash it. And what do you reckon, Dad?
Brilliant. Kilvo was great. Crowd were good. A little bit pissed up, I think, in the second half.
Yeah, they were shouting at me, "You scouse bastard!"
Oh,
and all that.
Yeah, well, just, they don't mean anything by.
No, I know.
Just
know,
a bit rough, but they were great. We're all right.
Yeah. And it's good to see our mate Jamie Connor.
Yeah, Jamie Connor.
Jamie Connor came in with his business partners or whatever they were.
Nutcases, yeah.
So big thanks to everyone who came along anyway. We're heading down to Skundo tomorrow, so we've got a nice little long drive home. 2.5 hours from here. Should be quite clear on the way home. Big thanks to everyone who came. Big thanks to the lads for organising it. Big thanks to Kilvo. Well done to Frank again for smashing it. Did you enjoy it?
I enjoyed it. When I went out into the second half, kind of like knew I'd have to work, it was getting late.
Yeah.
You do pissed when you were singing. So, you get a crowd like that, you got to kind of like work that a little bit harder to get their attention. But, you know, it worked and it went down great.
It was a late night.
Yeah,
ended
late
up getting wrapped up by about 11:30. Usually we're wrapped up by 10:30, 11 o'clock.
I don't know why, really. There was an auction and stuff to do in the middle and. Just seems to drag on.
Funny things are happening on the way home here. So we're driving home and basically we were doing a few live videos on the way back. In the show, weren't we? And with Jay last night and stuff. And then this troll has started trolling Jay. Kilvo on our Facebook page. He's from Northumberland. And he keeps saying, sorry guys, but Jay is not funny at all. What else did he say? Forced fake bullshit. But I don't think he's ever been to a show before. But Jay's proper bitten. Right, yeah. Let me show you this. Jay's proper bitten and he's written back to him. So the lads put, sorry guys, but this guy James is not funny at all. And he's put, mate, you haven't ever seen me perform. So you haven't even been to a show. So stop pretending. You have, and stop dressing like you're in the band Blink 182. You're about 65 year old, you. Grow up. He's proper bit, hasn't he?
No.
So what's your take on the troll?
Troll's just a fucking idiot. I mean, Jimmy's a great comedian.
It's mad the way people, look, you know what, I appreciate you coming onto our, you know, YouTube channel or Facebook or whatever the fuck it is and commenting and watching and all that, but at the same time, you just don't need to spread negative vibes like that, do you? Who's got the time to go on and say someone's not funny?
If he was a fantastic comedian himself, what does he do? Probably a fucking bus driver or something.
It's just mad, isn't it? Like, fair enough, you've got your opinion, but just don't throw those negative vibes around. It's just not good, is it?
It's just horrible, isn't it?
Yeah.
Why do people want to be nasty? I mean, even if he doesn't like Jimmy,
yeah,
why just keep his opinion to himself?
Yeah. Funny the way he's bit though, isn't it?
Oh yeah.
And he's saying he's proper trying to savage the fella.